All right, so today I want to compare the difference between the blade and the Enchi genes in ball pythons. And let me tell you, there's still quite a bit of confusion when it comes to the differences between blade and Enchi. As a matter of fact, about 5 years ago, I always thought that the blade was just a reduced version of clown. And if you actually take a blade clown side by side with a regular clown, the blade clown has a really reduced pattern. And then after I started looking into it a little bit more, I found that you can actually completely separate blade as a separate gene away from clown, and if you actually take the blade and line it up side by side with an Enchi, they look almost exactly the same. But looking over on the ads on Morphmarket, you can tell there's still quite a bit of confusion between the blade and the Enchi. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump over the internet and I want to show you some of the differences and a lot of the confusion between the blade and the Enchi ball pythons. All right, so I'm gonna jump over here at morphmarket.com, and I wanna start with the clown ball python, because originally I thought the blade was just a reduced version of the clown, and this is what a clown looks like. As a matter of fact, when I first started in ball pythons, people were going crazy over these clowns. I was like, what in the world is going on? This doesn't really look that impressive, and you really don't realize the potential of the clown until you start mixing it with other genes. And let me tell you, it is probably, I'd consider it like the king of combos as far as a recessive gene, working it into other combinations. It's pretty amazing. And this is what happens when you work blade into a clown. Take a look at this. It really reduces the pattern. And I've actually seen a lot of them listed over here as blade. This is actually a blade clown, and it actually lists it as a completely separate gene over here on Morphmarket. And I always thought it was just a reduced version of clown, that it wasn't actually a separate gene in the clown. But you can actually completely separate it from the clown. So as a matter of fact, if you actually take a blade clown and you breed it to something else, all the offspring don't look like clowns because it's recessive. They all come out as head clown, but half the offspring come out as blades. And take a look at this. This is what a blade looks like. Pretty amazing. It looks almost like an Enchi if you're familiar with the Enchi. And kind of the difference that I found between a lot of the blades and a lot of the Enchis is, I'd say overall, more of the blades seem to be really reduced into more tiger stripes. I've actually seen a lot of Enchis reduced into tiger stripes, but it seems like a lot of the blades kind of lean towards more of a striped combo versus, you know, kind of the reduced pattern of an Enchi. And you can actually make a super blade. Take a look at this. This is kind of where it kind of separates from the Enchi, in my opinion. I've actually seen some super blades that are really reduced into this tiger stripe patterns, where a lot of times you don't really see that with the Enchi. The Enchi usually reduces it even more. And kind of the interesting thing about the super blade is, a lot of times with the blade and the super blade, you don't really see a lot of the orangish yellow coming in that you would see in the Enchis. Of course, you see kind of exceptions all across the blades and the Enchis, and it seems like there's a lot more Enchis than blades over here on Morphmarket, so it's kind of hard to compare the two. So take a look at this. This is actually an Enchi. Looks almost exactly like the blade with the tiger stripes. Although it seems like with the blade, you have almost more kind of a, almost like a geometric shape with more similar shaped tiger stripes compared to the Enchi, where it's kind of has thicker stripes and thinner stripes, a little bit more jumbled up. And you can definitely see in the Enchi that it tends to bring out a lot of more of this orangish yellow in the Enchi. And take a look at this. I actually brought up a super Enchi, and this is kind of where it's separates from the blade, in my opinion. Comparing the super Enchi to the super blade, you can definitely see the super Enchi doesn't really have the tiger stripes. I don't think I've ever seen a super Enchi that has the tiger stripes in, like we actually compared to that super blade. It's usually a lot more reduced, and a lot of times the super Enchis can be really variable. I've actually seen some super Enchis with just little spots right on the top of the tank, super reduced. And you can definitely tell in this version of the super Enchi that it's actually bringing out a lot more of the kind of the orange color all through the snake. So take a look at this. This is actually a super Enchi clown, and this is where you can really see differences between the Enchi and the blade. So you can actually see with the super Enchi, it really reduces the pattern into almost like spots all along the top of the snake. And as a matter of fact, I actually have a banana Enchi clown that looks almost like a super Enchi. It's pretty amazing, the different lines of Enchi. I've seen some super Enchis where you can almost see just hardly any pattern, almost completely reduced produced on the top, and I'd say this is probably your more typical super Enchi clown. You see almost these little spots, and then you see a lot kind of the orange color coming through. And take a look at this, compare this to the super blade clown. Take a look at this, completely different when you're comparing the blade versus the Enchi. The blade, essentially what it does is it reduces all the pattern into kind of like a blade right down the back of the snake into this solid line. Pretty amazing difference. So you can actually take Enchi and blade and separate it completely, even, you know, removing the head clown and mix it in with other combinations. And I thought kind of the ideal comparison would be mixing it in with spider. And spider is kind of interesting because it actually works with Enchi to make a stinger bee. This is an Enchi spider. And you can definitely see on this one, it really breaks up the line that you see in the blade and kind of breaks it up into separate little spots along the top of the snake. Although you can definitely see kind of the spider web pattern of the spider in this combination. And let's compare this one to the blade version of that. This is the blade spider, and you can definitely see with the blade it really reduced kind of almost all into a single line right down the back of the snake. So, you know, pretty much everything we've seen so far, it looks like definitely the Enchi is different than the blade. They're definitely two different genes, but there's still a lot of confusion when it comes to some of the ads over here on Morphmarket. So take a look at this one. This is actually a Super Blade Enchi, which is, it's a little bit confusing. So the real question is blade just another line of Enchi? So for example, can you have a Super Blade Enchi, which is a little bit confusing. So if they were actually allelic, so if it was just another line of Enchi, technically you would have a blade Enchi and you breed it to something else, half the offspring would come out as blade, half would come out as Enchi, meaning they're just two different lines of Enchi, kind of had the blade version of Enchi. So for example, in this snake, you actually have a Super Blade Enchi, which technically would be impossible if the blade was just another version of Enchi. As a matter of fact, if you actually take a look at this ad, it actually lists down here in the bottom, it says, this snake was produced from a blade pinstripe clown to a blade Enchi clown. So I've actually seen this on a lot of combinations with, say for example, like Super Cinnamon and Black Pastel. It'll actually give you the breeding. And you have to kind of interpret the genes in some of these snakes over here on Morphmarket. So if they're actually compatible, if they're allelic and they're the same gene, just different lines of the same gene, that would mean that this would be either a Super Blade or it would be a blade Enchi. It couldn't be a Super Blade Enchi, which is kind of a big question mark in a lot of these ads. So take a look at this. This one's a little bit confusing too. This actually says this is a blade line of clown. So that kind of indicates to me that this is, you know, people are saying this is just a really a reduced version of the clown where it's not really able to separate the blade from the clown like you would think. This actually lists the two genes, the blade and the clown, but just the way it's this worded over here, the blade line of the clown, it seems like this is just a reduced version of the clown, where it's not separate, you're not able to separate the blade into a separate gene, which is originally what I thought was, you know, kind of the case at the very beginning. This is like going all the way back 5 years ago where I thought that the clown was just, you know, a reduced version of clown was a blade line of clown. That's originally what I thought that the blade was. So this ad is a little bit confusing too. So take a look at this. This is a little bit confusing too. This is actually the blade line of a Super Enchi, which indicates to me that this is just another line of Enchi. This is the blade line of the Super Enchi. So it gets really confusing looking at all these different ads. Is it really just a reduced version of the clown, or is the blade a separate line of Enchi where it's not all, you know, you actually can't have like a Super Blade Super Enchi because it's all the same gene, or is this, you know, it gets really confusing because you look at all these ads and there's still a lot of question marks. So I actually went over here, take a look at this. I went to the ball python genetic calculator to kind of test this theory. Are they actually the same or are they different? And I actually typed in Super Blade Super Enchi and I crossed it with an Enchi blade and calculated the results in the ball python genetic calculator. This is actually over on morphmarket.com, and it actually gave me a result of Super Blade Super Enchi, which indicates to me that they're completely separate genes, the blade and the Enchi, and they're not allelic, and that the blade is not a separate line of Enchi. You can actually have the two genes in one snake, which is pretty amazing. That is actually, I haven't actually seen a super blade, super Enchi over here, but it's kind of confusing because you actually have some listed as like super Enchi blade, and it's kind of the same way, you know, with some of the other genes, you can actually list them over here as that, but it's, you know, technically not possible. So I actually tested my genetic calculator to see if these results were accurate, and I actually typed this in. I typed in the super lesser, super Mojave, which is technically impossible because the lesser and the Mojave are allelic, meaning you really can't have four of the same genes in one snake or that are in the same complex. So you actually type in super lesser, super Mojave and hit calculate, and the genetic calculator actually errors out. It says invalid input. Parents can't have more than two genes of any complex. Lesser Mojave. So yeah, you actually can't do this in the genetic calculator. And I kind of went one step further. Take a look at this. This is another one. A lot of people actually list some of their combinations over here as a super cinnamon black pastel, which is also technically impossible because black pastel is allelic with super cinnamon. So black pastel and cinnamon are allelic. So it's either a super cinnamon or it's a cinnamon black pastel. You can't have both. And this one also aired out, and it says you can't have more than two genes of any complex, which indicates to me that according to the genetic calculator, that, you know, the final answer that I found over here on Morphmarket is that that blade is completely separate than the Enchi, and you actually can have a super blade, super Enchi ball python. All right, so it is time for the question of the day. And Young FC asks, if you have a 2-year-old ball python that's underfed and is smaller than it should be, can it actually catch up to a regular size with increased feeding? And that is a very good question. As a matter of fact, the same thing happened to me. I actually found a snake over on Craigslist a few years ago. Essentially what happened is a guy had a roommate, and the roommate moved out and left his ball python behind. And the other guy, he really didn't know anything about ball pythons. He was feeding it a small mouse once a month. Pretty incredible. Not really enough. You should actually feed a hatchling ball python like every 4 to 5, maybe every at least once a week, and he was feeding it once a month. And essentially you're supposed to transition from mice over to rats once they get a certain size, and if you keep feeding it like once a month just a small mouse, let me tell you, they stay really small. And when I actually found that ball python and went to pick it up, it was almost the size of a hatchling. I couldn't believe that it was a year old, and I started feeding that thing 3 times a week. It would eat every single time that I offered it food, and that thing grew like a rocket. And let me tell you, within a couple years it was big enough to breed. It was pretty amazing. And let me tell you, if you stunt the growth of a snake, they can definitely catch up really quick. So that is pretty much it. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.